right now to the wrong screen. Hold on. There we go. All right. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Beef Stream, the Beefy Boys number 26, number 4, I guess, for the podcast. We're live here, as always, every Thursday night. That's right, Thursday night, instead of Friday. We've moved that on Twitch.tv/TheBeefiestBoys. I'm your host, Tyler Bickham, at Tyler_Bickham on Twitter. With me tonight is my co-host and longtime frenemy, Prude, at Turf_Cat on Twitter. And also we got here Mez, who is, I don't know what your Twitter handle is.
I choose not to disclose it.
Yeah, for legal reasons. He's unless under deposition, he's not actually.
There's a whole lot of Fetty snakes, and I don't.
Sure. Biggest snakes on the Fetty. Anyway, another week. I know we're waiting on Prude to get back. I think he went to hunt for some snacks, but let's get that snack check. Personally, I had a little bit of ice cream before the show. What you got, Mez?
I just did dinner. I did like chow mein sauce with some fresh broccoli and chicken.
Ooh.
And just some spaghetti noodles because, you know,
yeah.
I know I wasn't around for last week's episode, so I'll give everybody a bit of a background.
Okay.
My wife is now cripple wife. She decided to step off the curb the other day going to work and fractured one ankle and severely sprained the other.
Mm-hmm.
And she's wheelchair bound.
Many such cases. What's the recovery time on that look like?
So she's got a follow-up with the orthopedist on the 1st, but okay. As it stands right now, she's indefinitely cripple wife until she heals.
That's great. That's fucking great.
In a boot, no soft cast, just a boot.
Right. Well, that's fucking great. All right, Prude, what you got, snack?
Let's grab like a small handful of pistachios.
Okay, that's always good.
Very respectable.
Yeah, it's always good to have some nuts in your diet. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Not going to even parlay that into a joke. Just, it's good to have nuts in your diet, so.
They're good fiber. I've actually had episodes where I've, like, eaten way too many pistachios, and it kind of, like, fucked me up. It constipated me because there's so much fiber in them.
Gross. Absolutely fucking gross. Thanks for sharing. All right. Suck in chat says he's having eel fudges. All right, let's go.
Eel
fudges?
E-L. E and E, the letter E. And the letter L. E-L fudges.
Okay.
Never heard of that, but okay. Move on from that into our new opening segment, which I'm now going to call News Around the Wideverse, where we're going to talk about shit we got going on. We might do a little... Mez said we're going to do game chat from now on, which I like the sound of that. That sounds good.
Yeah, as we ramp up into quarter three, you know, it's and into quarter four. Those are the big game seasons. Like summer's the drought, mm-hmm. So things are going to be ramping up. Talk about games maybe we're interested in. You know,
well,
did you buy a game that you hated.
Yeah,
you
know, and I tell you what, we got Gamescom next month. That feels like a live stream event. That sounds like a good one for that. I was gonna say we started last night watching on Weird Wednesday. We started watching Stargate Atlantis, which. Man, I forgot how much I love that show. That was, like, I was a big SG-1 guy, of course. I mean, who wasn't? But, Atlantis absolutely fucked. But, we started that last night for Weird Wednesday. And tomorrow night, of course, the reason why we have moved the show. Tomorrow night, finally, thank God, after almost, over 2 years. 2 years and a month, I believe. Live PD coming back. Fucking finally, man. Fucking
right,
finally.
That's right.
And I cannot wait. Only problem is it's not back on A&E. It's not back on any station you've ever heard of. It's on Reels. And raise your hand if you have Reels, because I'm not raising my hand.
I don't even know what the fuck that is.
I don't have any TV stations.
I had it on Direct. But of course, I've talked about it on another episode. I dropped Direct earlier this year. I moved to YouTube TV, and YouTube TV is not. I won't say it's slim pickings. They have the good shit. But if you're looking for something very niche like Reels, have I found a stream for it? Potentially, we'll see tomorrow night. But I cannot wait. I love live PD, and it's really a shame they got rid of it. That was, I mean, the reasoning behind that was utter bullshit.
It is very Ishima. I think it is probably, because I mean I'll be honest, and I'm sure, I don't know if you guys do, Cops is very, very doctored.
Yeah. Oh yeah, everyone knows that. Fake,
it's doctored, but Live PD was probably the best slice of reality so people would see what the day to day is for law enforcement.
Yeah. No, I mean it was really good, and even the guys, fucking Dan Abrams, when he was doing it. Well, he's still doing it, but when it happened, when it got taken off the air, he was talking about, he said, I understand your anger, I understand the backlash against Cops, whatever, but you can't look at what we're doing here and go, this is wrong. I mean, what we're showing is, you know, nothing's doctored. Yeah, there's some pre-tape segments, but it's just live. It is literally live Cops. Whatever happens. And it's a great look into how police have to operate. And I thought it was great. It was great because it, well, you know why? Well, the real reason why they hated it was to humanize Cops. That was why. If we're going to be serious. So, but yeah, no. Fucking ecstatic it's coming back, bro. A little upset it's coming back right as football's about to start. But you know, what it is.
You could just cut down on football and watch Live PD instead.
No. Speaking of football, though, me and Suck earlier were talking about thinking about that college football show. Think about that college football show. I said maybe we do that like Saturday nights, like 11 Eastern, after, you know, after like the big night games ended. Maybe while like a little Pac-12 after dark is still going on, while the Pac-12 still exists. And we might want to hurry up with that because the Pac-12 may be done in a year or two, but. Yeah, it'll be fun. Probably stick with the branding of my old show from 2019, College Football Shitposting Live, but now it will actually be live. So I'm looking forward to that too. That's gonna be fun. We got a lot coming up actually around the Wideverse. So I'm very excited.
Exciting times. Exciting times.
And then to circle all the way back to the beginning with talking about games, we've gotten back into Ready or Not. Which is
very, very fun.
Man. And I tell you what, I'll let you go off on here for a second, but we played it Sunday afternoon. We played that new level, the Chomo level. Valley of the Dolls. You want to talk about a game that does exceptional atmospheric storytelling without saying a word? That one. I've got the recording where we're just going through it, and like, well, you know, the first couple of times we're not making it very far, but you know, we get through and we're like, because the basis of the level is you're serving a search warrant on an alleged Chomo, a guy that's running a CSAM ring, and you're in there. It's like there's some young, you know, he's also like a mainstream pornographer too. So you get in there and he's got like a bunch of posters up on the walls of like porn stuff, but it all looks above board. You know, it's all just, it's scummy, but whatever. And then you get into the fucking basement, and then all hell breaks loose. It was funny in a very dark way. Because every room you would go into, it was like, oh no, I wish I didn't see that.
The kicker is too, is you're serving that warrant in the middle of his 18-year-old stepdaughter's birthday party, yeah, too.
Who he was definitely abusing, 100%.
Huh.
100%. I don't actually...
No, I'm going to disagree on that. I think he was like, oh, you're 18 now, haha, like you want to like homework the family...
Oh, I see. So the only ones that were getting, well, spoiler alert, they were getting dumped into oil drums was those fucking African kids he was taking pictures with. Oh, God, man, it's funny. Again, it's not funny. It's not funny at all. But when we were going through it in the context of him being, you know, an alleged Chomo, he, in his office, he had these pictures of him hugged up to like African children. He was helping or whatever. It's like, we just kind of jokingly went, oh, haha, that's creepy. And then you get down to the basement. It's like, oh, okay, well, that took a much darker turn. And that has like the implication of that now is terrifying. So
it really is.
Yeah.
Really,
so really, that's really fucking what a game.
Very fun. The dev team is, very, very dangerously based.
Now, talk to me about this, because you've brought up the idea of adding some mods into it. It's a modded game. I believe it's built in Unity.
I'm not sure. I don't want to say yes or no either way.
Well, regardless, it's very moddable, apparently. And talk to me about that.
So they fully support and embrace their modding community, unlike a lot of devs that are, you know, for the most part, they hate debt. They hate anybody that wants to mess with their, you know, golden sheep of, you know, our game. They are very open. I think this most recent update that dropped 4 or 5 days ago actually changed the modding structure, so it's easier for mod developers to make packages for the games. So you'll have a lot of mods that are going to be able to interact now. In terms of actual mods that I've messed with, just basic things, things that have unlocked weapons that are used by the AI, some weapons that were removed due to testing reasons, like an M24 bolt action.
I
And
think
other than that,
I think personally that's the best mod too, because there is some stuff that's either like, not available for whatever reason. There's some supporter stuff. I don't know if it unlocks it. That might be a little unfair, but there's a bunch of stuff that's locked behind either, so it's not put in, or there's mob only, like P90, specifically in
so
Valley of the Dolls. Go ahead.
they're big on they'll put a weapon in for a couple patches to look for feedback and then take it out so that they can work on it. Like they're very dynamic in their testing, which I like and I think leads to a lot of the goodwill they have with their player base. So like I know the M24 was in when I first got the game like over a year ago, and then it was taken out because at the time there's only very small maps and there's one or two larger maps now, but even then I don't think there's anything to justify having a sniper because the majority of Ready or Not is room clearing. If any of you guys have grown up playing SWAT 4, it's effectively the truest form of a spiritual successor to SWAT 4 that I've ever played.
Now, you talked about big maps. When we played in January, I believe, one of our favorite levels was the meth house, which in and of itself was fairly large because you had both the house, you had a backyard yard, and then the backyards had a small tunnel section. You were telling me the other night that the meth house level now has the entire street open?
Yes, it does. So there
That's nuts.
is if you do it on the because there's multiple modes for everybody who's not played the game, maps support actually have the game open now. I will tell you the modes that are supported for most maps. So there's your standard barricaded suspects, which are, your whole team is deployed to rescue civilians, detain suspects. And your rules of engagement are very strict. There's no firing first, there's no Wyatt Earp. You have to ask for compliance, and you're only really able to shoot unless they shoot back, because you will be penalized for unauthorized use of force, unauthorized use of deadly force. And obviously, because it is a game, you're incentivized to get a higher score. There's actually a pretty active speedrunning community for
Really?
the game. Yeah.
I'm gonna have to
The
look
other
that
mode
up.
is there's raid, which is more of like your suspects are more aggressive, they might be armed better, they might patrol a little harder. They're not going to give up as easily, and your rules of engagement are a little bit loosened, so you can kind of shoot first depending on the situation. You're going to have long engagements and firefights if you don't end them quickly, because the AI is very smart now. It makes heavy use of cover, flanking, traps. There's also the active shooter mode, which is a harder mode. There's a gunman on the move, shooting civilians and killing them in a frenzy, like your standard, angry 22-year-old loner who's been groomed and given a rifle by the CIA or FBI,
Allegedly.
allegedly, in Ready or Not.
Yeah, and ready or not, yeah.
And the whole point of that is to end the threat. You don't want to do what Uvalde PD did. You want to go in, stop
Jesus.
the threat, drop them fast. Oh, fuck them, man. We'll
Fucked
save
up.
that
No,
for a
I was gonna say fucked up,
we'll
but true,
we'll
but
save
true.
that for a BP special. There's a lot I can say after seeing the full report and the surveillance footage. Other than that, there's bomb threat. It's a bomb threat. It's pretty
It's a bomb threat.
straightforward. I don't think that don't need that think that needs to be explained. And then hostage rescue. I've not really done a lot of hostage rescue just because everything I've heard and everything I read is that is your five man, all the boys are on mode.
We
Because
did some hostage rescue last time, and I think we were only at four people, and it was, yes, it was a nightmare.
one of the rooms in a map will be picked as the hostage room where the hostage takers are. And I know in certain maps it's split between two rooms. And the whole point is to ID where the hostage room is. And once you've found the hostage room, formulate a plan to breach clear, bring everybody home alive, and hopefully the hostage takers too, because the easy way out isn't always the best for those pieces of shit. Sometimes spending time in Supermax is fun. But the modes, man, I mean, they just add so much depth to some of these maps, like the 315 Park Homes, which is everyone calls meth. A barricaded suspect, it's a very small map, very confined. It's, your usual low-income housing, shitty street block. You do it on raid, you've got to clear a laundromat, you've got to clear
Oof.
a parking lot, you've got to clear side streets, footpaths, and the whole street, along with two houses.
Jesus Christ.
And the cartel meth dealers, whatever they are, you know, pieces of shit. They're moving between the houses. They're moving up and down the street. They're moving, and it's, oof, is it, it can get, it can it get hectic?
That sounds hectic. I mean, we were having a trouble last time when we were playing the hostage on gas station. I can't even imagine that. But yeah, I mean, it's very fun. I've enjoyed it, and it's great. It's a really good multiplayer game, especially for, you know, like an older group of gaming friends, because it is very, I want to say it's a little sweaty, but not to the point that you're going to be raging, because it's more tactical and strategic than twitchy.
Absolutely. I think that's probably the best way to put it. It's very fun with friends to sit down, because while it is a shooter, it's also really, if you think about it, a puzzle game.
Hmm. Very much so, because again, a little unsaid was, especially like Valley of the Dolls, there's more than one way to skin that cat. You can,
yeah, we had some very rough parts.
Yes, we did. And I believe the first time we took the hardest route by going downstairs first and working our way up, and then after that we essentially every single time we went through the front door. And now sometimes even going through the front door was rough. There was one, I believe, where all like four of the 10 guards, I believe, something in that area, four of them were in that first little area and just absolutely mowed us down. Mowed us down. So, very rough.
And you saw it when we were doing Valley of the Dolls. Like, it's actual room clearing. Like, it's terrifying to go through an exposed second floor hallway, because you can get shot from the bottom floor. Mm-hmm. People in the hallway. It is terrifying.
It is not fun. No, it's not fun. It is very rough. And I mean, even I like, yeah, I mean, you know, it's just a game. It's just a game, but it gets the heart rate up. No lie. Yeah, and, no lie.
Before we move off the subject, I do want to give a shout out to Void Interactive, the developers for this game. They are, and I'm not saying this to be pedantic or making fun of them, they are actually pretty brave for some of the stuff they've did. Their most recent map that they put out was a nightclub map. Heavily influenced. I'm not saying this to be based off of the Pulse nightclub shooting from
16.
And originally they had a actual publisher prior to this, and they had said very before, like, you know, hey, we're, many of our devs are former law enforcement or part-time law enforcement. We work heavily with active law enforcement and military guys for consultation. And we're going to show you realistic SWAT call outs. So the Pulse nightclub map being one of them, there is going to be a school shooter map. And when their publisher found that out, their publisher said, no, that's not happening. You will not be making these maps.
Mm-hmm.
So what Void Interactive said, they literally said, for lack of a better term, and excuse my language, we're going to get us demonetized here. They told their publisher to go fuck themselves and broke their contract with their publisher. And they're now 100% unpublished.
That reminds me a little bit of that game. What is it? 10 Days in Fallujah, that has gotten a lot of controversy for like giving a very, very real look of the Iraq war.
That game was slated to come back in like 06 or 07, and I remember it's been canned
like five times. I think it's gone through two or three publishers for the exact same reasons, because publishers went, we don't want the bad publicity, because some fucking blue hair in their HR department, you know, saw a tweet that got two likes that said, I'm not playing this game, and they went, well, threw their hands up and went, well, sorry, can't do anything about it. Rip. So yeah, very, very base that when you have a vision for something that you want to do and people keep telling you, no, you can't do that. You can't do that, especially, you know, in the atmosphere today, or, you know, we have to view this to this. And no, just fuck off. I want to tell the story I'm going to fucking tell. And that's what you do. And that's based. It doesn't. And at that point, it doesn't matter if you sell one copy or a million copies. You've succeeded. 100%.
And I mean, the player base seems very enthusiastic. I mean, yeah, the monetization model for Freddynauts is not the best. There's two. It's early access. There's the base at $40, and then there's a upgrade to their supporter edition, which is pricey. It's $80. It's not, you know, nothing to scoff
at. But frankly, given the depth of the game, the replayability, and the fact that they're doing this essentially on their lonesome, I fully endorse.
I paid for that not because I wanted the skins that came with it. I mean, I respect the bravery of these guys to. I mean, this is the most realistic game I have ever played outside of like full on mil sim, like arma modding and stuff. And that's just unfun.
Yeah.
I mean, this is
no fuck arma.
Realistic.
Like ARM, I was actually thinking about this, and let me get a plug in here real quick, and then we'll keep talking about this. Speaking of supporting, did you know you can support the Beefy Boys? It's very easy.
Really?
It's very easy. It's very easy. Do you guys know what Twitch Prime is?
No, tell me about this, Taylor. What is
Twitch Prime is a perk of Amazon Prime, and it gives you one free Prime subscription a month. That's free. Well, you're paying for Amazon Prime, but it's free. You could drop it on us. It helps. Or maybe you're just an old-fashioned USD kind of guy. Patreon.com/WMG. That's WMG for Wide Media Group. Could help us out there. You know, we really appreciate the support.
We should probably switch that to Libera Pay at some point, but
You know what? We'll do a couple of them. What?
Monero.
I'm not a crypto guy. I'm not like an alternate currency guy. I know Patreon and I know Twitch Prime. That's it. We can look into other stuff, but as it stands right now, that's all we have because that's all I know. Look, it's funny for a guy who hosts, you know, several shows about, you know, internet stuff. I don't know a lot of this deeper shit. Like,
Libera Pay is literally just Patreon that won't deplatform you.
Okay, like, we'll look into Libera Pay. We'll look into Libera Pay. But for now, patreon.com/WMG. That's what we've got. Twitch Prime. I know we got about a few people that do that. Re-up. Appreciate it. We appreciate all the support. Love you. But... And now I've completely forgotten what I was talking about. No, I didn't. ARMA. I was thinking about ARMA the other day, actually. And the only version of ARMA that I've ever really liked was we did the Exile mod, which that's gone. That doesn't exist anymore. That's completely defunct. Which, it was a little janky. It's fine. But the only ARMA I ever really liked was the Altus Life. Is that a thing?
That's like the roleplay mod, right?
Yeah. I didn't mind that. We did Alt. I think Altus is the map and Life is the ARMA.
Altus is the actual, the map.
That's ARMA. The Greek map that I believe is the one that got them in so much trouble, right?
I thought it was because some of their devs got in trouble for like fucking Russian fighter jet plans or something.
No, I'm pretty sure they were taking pictures outside of a Greek.
Really?
I want to say yes. I will look through here.
They got accused of being Turkish spies. Then if it's the Greeks,
maybe I'll find it. But yeah, I believe it was this map because this was the new one for ARMA 3. And but that was, man, this is a really good map. We played. This was something we did on the early days of the BMW Arc era of Wideverse. We were pretty big into this. I forgot what the other map we played. That one was a Russian town or some sort of vaguely Slavic bullshit. But we got pretty heavy into it. And then we went to this. We played Altus. And I think we were still playing Exiles. But, you know, you can get into all sorts of bullshit with ARMA and different autistic modes of very minute, like, milsim shit. But to be fair, the most fun part of ARMA was literally just driving around in your armored personnel carrier, just fucking around with the lads. That's really it. That's really it. I'm not a big milsim guy. I'm not a big spurg when it comes to, like, you know, we have to have a very, you know, precise tactics and call-outs. Now, funny, coming off of talking about Ready or Not, I do like that in Ready or Not because it's on a much smaller scale. Police sim is not at all in the same ballpark as milsim spurging. Not even remotely close. Milsim dudes are like fucking... I tell you what, like over in the Discord, when it's specifically like Steve and Trips, when they get going on a milsim thing, I just got to mute the fucking channel because I'm like, okay, y'all have a good one. Y'all here? Y'all have a good one. So I just can't do it.
So I could enjoy a certain amount of milsim. Like, I picked up Squad a while back because I have a coworker who's like, will not shut up about how much he loves Squad. And it's fun. But it's definitely one of those games that I feel like if we had a couple boys playing it, it'd be way more fun. Because it's got a bit of a learning curve, but it's fun when it gets going, man. Like, it's fun. It's a team builder. And it's very fun for that.
And now, you mentioned that, and when we were talking about milsim, you can't help but think about autism, about guns. And before we went live, you were talking about Tarkov, which is interesting. Because I've always thought Tarkov is interesting. People have talked me out of it previously, but you're saying, I believe you were talking about doing, you're doing the offline hack.
There is an offline, I wouldn't say it's a hack now,
it's a
it's like a
mod.
full-on supported mod, yeah.
Yeah.
My issue with Tarkov's always been, like, it's so hard to get into if you don't play at the start of a seasonal wipe, because it's a full loot game, like,
Oh yeah.
Eventually people just, they amass so much loot, it ceases to be fun, because people are just literally beating the fucking shit out of you with their very good gear. And from what I understand, there, you know, there's RPG elements to it.
Yeah.
So a friend pointed out that there is an offline mode now. You can actually...
that's what I'm looking at right now on the...
If you want to get technical, it really doesn't cost you any money. Because you're spooling up an offline server. There will never be multiplayer. The devs have said, like, well, it's possible we will never, ever put it out because that puts us in legal hot water.
Right.
Which is, you know, I respect that.
Sure.
But their whole point is sometimes you just want to play offline. And apparently the devs, like, it's something the devs have been asked about since 2017. And they just have refused to do anything for it. Like, I think they're doing like a 4-on-4 squad-based shooter mode now before they're even putting in a single-player mode.
Ugh, fuck off. No, I want to stop you. You said that about the online. Man, this would be cool to be able to play it offline, but with like two or three other bros. A
couple boys, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That would be awesome. That sucks that you can't do that. I'm sure that someone will unofficially do something that allows you to do that, but...
Oh sure, not a doubt in my mind, but
that sounds like that's starting to sound like
launchers and stuff.
Yeah,
and
then, or is something you have to start fucking around with Hamachi or something. Ugh.
Or, you know, the guy repacks it and puts in a fucking Bitcoin miner.
Well, I don't think that's even worth it anymore to do that, but yeah. Man, okay, that's kind of cool. How much is Tarkov? It's still fairly expensive, right?
So it's one of those games, there's like multiple versions.
Oh, okay. Scheme.
I've considered it just because I like the idea of it, you know, like what it's supposed to be. But
yeah, and interestingly enough, this plays a little bit into something we were talking about the other day. How, I'd like to talk about this for a little bit actually. I thought, yeah, I just see. I re-downloaded Rust, you know, because we haven't played Rust in a coon's age. Which I looked that up. That's not racist. It's not racist. Just want to get that out of the way. That's not racist.
You're just talking about raccoons.
Yeah, no, it literally is. I mean, that's the basis of it. That's not the point. Not the point. So we haven't played in ever. I think the last time I personally seriously played Rust, May and June 2017, when we were playing me, Korns, Gorzak, and I want to say... Julia Child, if anybody remembers him. We played with a group called TSS, the Salt Shakers, which was a group around Nonpoint, if anybody remembers him, which was pretty fun. We played on a server, I believe, called like Blueberry GG or something. And interestingly enough, on that server, we found out a group that we used to fight with. Prude, you might specifically remember Nambla.
Yeah,
Nambla was on there. It was funny because we wiped the fucking floor with them. Because remember, they were such a formidable threat when we played them on the Terminus Gaming server.
Right.
For backstory here, Nambla was a clan in Rust. They were on a server we were on in early 2016 called, late 2015, early 2016, called Terminus Gaming. And from the get-go, it was very sketchy. The whole thing was very, very sketchy because they always had this ability to, like, know...
I don't mean to stop you. Explain what is Rust? Like, what kind of game is it?
Well, let me finish the story, and then we'll go into that. Rust is what was an early access survival game, FPS elements, you know, hunger, base building, and stuff. So yeah, actually that does help. Thank you. Because it gives some context here. So when these guys would be sketchy, they would be trying to break into a base or something. And first off, they always knew where your base specifically was. They could pinpoint what, you know, well, again, BMW bases always look fairly similar. But then again, not too similar to the fact that they could just beeline to one and blow it up. Secondly, one of the more suspicious things was it was late night and there was a base that we'd built down in the desert, and I knew like two or three of them were raiding it, and I had a teleport, like a little shit shack, way off to the side, way away. I snuck about 500 meters in complete darkness, fucking doing squad shit, right? Fucking, you know, through the mud of Vietnam on my belly, which, I mean, you can't go prom, but you know what I mean, like absolute sneak mode. I round the corner and three of them are waiting for me and fill me full of lead. Now, in retrospect, my assumption is one of their players was probably given admin. And he could do the free cam thing, which I'm going to go ahead and admit, when I was an admin on Rusty Bottoms, which is another server we played on, I abused the shit out of free cam. All the time. Now, I will say this, to not let it delegitimize my legacy as the Bass Whisper, that was only a month of our time on Rusty Bottoms. Everything else I did where I could just predict where shit was, that was real, because I didn't have that. So, but yeah, then after that, it was one of those things where it was like, I would still guess where something was, and then I would free cam too, and I was like, oh, okay, I'm right. So, still, I mean, I don't want to downplay my legacy as the Bass Whisper, because I was really good at that. But I definitely abused it a little bit. And in retrospect, that's probably what they were doing. They would go around and they would free cam into bases and go, a BMW person is asleep in here, because that's what's happened in Rust. When you fell asleep,
so your body persisted. Okay.
When you log out. Now, some servers turned that off, which was interesting. And frankly, that was abusable as shit, because you could put all your good stuff on that body and log out, and it's essentially removed from the game until that person logs in. So you could never lose anything good unless that person was online. So that's what they would do. They would probably free cam. And yeah, in retrospect, that makes way more sense than anything else, because one of a BMW member, Method Man, was also an admin on the server, and he vehemently denied any abuse, which, if that had been true, would have been right. There would have been no abuse from the main admin. There would have been abuse from the NAMBLA guy that was made an admin, or some sort of mod or something. But in retrospect, that's probably how they saw me coming. That's how they knew where all our bases were, everything. But anyway, yeah, it was all very sketchy. And then it was even made sketchier by the fact that not even, well, a year and change later, same guys, same clan, same game, gets the absolute floor wiped with them. Like, I mean, our raid, it was a full frontal, straight up the gut raid. Not a single casualty did we take. And it was pretty much a one-to-one battle, uphill too. So, and it was so weird. And I was taunting them the whole time. I was like, what happened, guys? Y'all used to be crack shots. Y'all used to knew we were coming. What's going on here, baby? What's going on here, baby? You suck now. And they were not happy, and they left the server. We have a great video of that on our YouTube, where we put games, which I cannot actually tell you to go to easily, because it's not like a YouTube / Wideverse. It's like a, you know, alphanumeric bullshit. We need a link tree or something. That'd help. I'll work on that later.
Yeah.
Freedom links or whatever. Yeah. Whatever. God damn it, you people and your fucking alternative service.
Well, it's just, you know.
I know.
You do it once and then you don't got to worry about it.
You're right. But anyway, that was that's what old preachers in the South used to call chasing a rabbit. Anyway, I done chased that rabbit. Let me get back to my point. Rust. So that was the last time I played Rust, and it was all right. But ever since then, we played a little bit in 2019, but not. I played with Korzak a little bit. That game is just crazy. There's all this shit now. There's like, so you know, back in the day, like the airfield was one of the, like, it was probably the biggest landmark, and it was literally just like three hangars. That's it. That's it. The airfield now is fucking nuts. So it's still got like the three hangars, but there's way more shit in it. There's like control towers. There's this big building that's got a bunch of shit in it, like furnaces and everything. There's like occasional drops that you can't just open up. You have to like hack, and it takes 7 minutes for the hack to run. So you have to defend it while it's hacking. Oh my God, it's crazy. And then at each landmark, at each of the major landmarks, there's this huge shaft that you can take an elevator down, and it takes you all the way down into like these old abandoned railway tunnels that are full of these guys with fucking automatic machine guns that will blow you away. It is nuts. But anyway,
it's pretty also AI and PvP?
Yes, it's NPCs. There's tons of NPCs in the game now. There's friendly NPCs that have their own little settlements that you can trade with using scrap as a currency.
That's the part that's the most interesting that would make me want to try it again.
It is, like, but this is my point to bring it back to Tarkov. All those elements of that can pretty much just be found in Tarkov, except I'm not certain if there's like a lot of underground railway shit in Tarkov, but...
There's like some indoor maps, yeah. I've really played the game like three times.
But yeah, that's what I was saying. Like, that was the most interesting part. Like, why I moved away from Rust was the game became, when we first played it, it truly was early access. Like, not many people were playing it. It wasn't that big. I think the game had like 17,000 players, which now it has like 100.
Well, it was also a very pure sandbox in that stage too. You know, it was very pure in terms of making your own fun. Like, there was no real direction in terms of like you had to work with the jank you were provided.
You had to, like, everything you did was something you had to do. There wasn't, you know, you couldn't go find the best shit in the game. There was no NPCs, there was no landmarks. Like I said, the airfield was pretty much the biggest one, and it was just three hangars. That was it. And it was always so funny how angry people used to get when we cordoned it off. You can't do that. Oh, you can't do that anymore. You can't build on landmarks, which I think is the dumbest part. Like, so... Yeah, it's very on rails now. But more importantly, like, yeah, when we first started playing, 17, 15,000 people, somewhere in that range. And it was all really, like, older guys, right? Older, like, spurgy sim guys who, you know, were decent as shooters, probably, like, Arena Quake guys in their youth. But after the 2015 Steam winter sale, first time it ever went on sale, bunch of CSGO kids got in on it, and that the game.
And I would say that, like, there's also a certain element in, like, YouTube so-called content creators making
that was years later, the only
exposure to Rust I know is like a single webm of like a guy throwing a rock in the air and killing some little kid.
That was a good one, and that was fairly early days. I know that webm you're talking about. It's a good one. I think that was actually in CSGO anime. It's a pretty good one. Yeah, that was fairly early days. Yeah, so yeah, but the Steam winter sale was the first, like, downhill point. You got a bunch of CSGO kids. It became less a survival thing, and it was more like a shooter. And you got to this point where you would log on to, like, you would be on your server or whatever, and you'd be a pretty decent little community. You'd have some people who came through, but it was usually the same people. But after all the CSGO kids started playing, you'd literally have kids, like, log in who would just, like, beg to join a clan so they could, like, get an AK and go roam and just, like, RDM, for lack of a better word, random deathmatch, which was kind of annoying, because it's like they're just completely ignoring the survival aspect of it. They just want to, like, run and gun for absolutely no purpose. It's like,
they just want to, like, loot your shit.
It's like, yeah, they want to play CSGO but full loot CSGO. But then, yeah, Prude, you're right. 2017-2018, Gary and his infinite cucked wisdom started this bullshit where he says, you know, all right, we're gonna reach out to streamers, we're gonna get titty streamers to play this, and it blew the fuck up. And, like, to this day, there's still, like, you know, streamer exclusive servers, which is funny because towards the tail end of when we played in, like, 2016, I tried so hard for us to get on and fuck with Andy Milanakis, who was playing Rust, and I found the server he was on. I was like, guys, we could do this, it'd be legendary. And that was when BMW had kind of, well, Wideverse had kind of gotten stagnant. Everyone was like, I don't really matter. It's like, it's fucking Andy Milanakis. You don't want him to rage on stream? That would be legend fucking but my point in all of that is, it does seem like escape from Tarkov in a single player mode would definitely kind of fill the niche that I was looking for.
It's pretty noided, bro. Like, this game's all about, like, hearing sounds, and autism to the level of, like,
dude,
matching armor piercing ammo types to the correct type.
Thinking this the other day. Was there anything better? And I hate to do the nostalgia thing. I hate to do it, but I'm gonna. Was there anything better than 2014-2015 Rust? Especially, I know both of them, where the game, it was new, you didn't know a lot about it, and it was very much not like the run and gun thing. And you, it was because one other thing I remember so specifically was when we started playing on the Goon server and we allied with GM, which is a lot. I mean, several people we still know, Jack and Kim and all of them. I was so crazy because you were constantly looking behind your back. Even with your allies, the game was noited as hell. Yeah, like you would be going through somewhere and you're like, it's like, do I see a dude? Do I see mans? I need to freak out. And even like, yeah, your allies, like you still keep an eye on your allies every so often because that game, you would turn on dudes in that game in a heartbeat. Mm-hmm. So, man.
Yeah, there's a lot of like server politics.
There was. Too. There really, really was. Oh my God, I loved it. But yeah, it's not like that anymore. Between like, you know, Twitch streamer ball riders, Korean Zergs. It's just, I think if you found a small enough server, it might work, but there's just so many other games that do this, something similar that I appreciate where it's gone, but not for me.
The game has just changed.
It's just too much. Sucks saying 2014 WildStar, man. Yeah, that was good too. That game sucked. It wasn't really that fun, but the community around WildStar was chef kiss. Absolutely love it. Couldn't ask for better. Oh, okay. Well, I was afraid we weren't gonna have anything to talk about, and we haven't even hit any news yet.
I mean, gaming was good to talk about, man. I mean,
yeah. Let's get into some news.
It's news to me. I have a Steam Deck coming on Saturday.
He does have a Steam Deck coming on Sunday.
The ultimate soy boy catnip.
Are you soy facing as you say that?
I am. Yeah, I can't wait to have Melissa's boyfriend come over and, you know, buy me a game.
Yeah. You should watch that video that Linus Tech Tips did recently about dumping like ROMs onto your Steam Deck so you just turn into a Switch, which is hilarious.
So I already have that. I have emulation station ready to go. I have all the BIOS files.
Oh, let's fucking go.
Acquire backup. So
of course, yes. Oh, okay. Yes, of course.
Game backups.
I'd have to think about it, but yeah, probably somewhere. Yeah. Okay. I've been thinking about the game deck, but like,
Well, for me, for work, like as long as I have Wi-Fi, man, I can game and just about everything. I could.
Yeah.
Ready or not is verified on the Steam Deck.
Yeah. Is do you think you can get Fortnite working on it?
I don't know.
Maybe. Well,
that all depends on the easy anti-cheat.
Yeah, sure. That's actually a good point. Speaking of easy anti-cheat, that's not a segue. How y'all feeling about these new Niji Sanjis?
What the fuck is that? I don't know what any
of that means. Do y'all want to watch the trailer?
What is it? I don't understand.
VTubers. If you're watching if you're watching this show on Twitch, Twitch TV / the Beefiest Boys, or if you're watching, listening to this on
within 250 feet of a school, you guys aren't obviously because you're like YouTubers, but
what? I have the cleanest criminal record in this entire group.
This NCIC printout says otherwise.
I mean, I know that's lie because you would only see two things and both of them are literal nothing. One of them would be an expired license and one of them would be, speeding. Oh no, running a red stop sign. Sorry, rolling stop through a stop sign. Fuck off. God, man. Ugh. I'm not going to get off in a rant, but man, that pissed me the fuck off. It's like, I inched over the line and he lit me up and it was, and he came over and I was like, I'm sorry. And he went, and he was just riding that ticket as fast as he could. I'm like, God damn it. Fucking anyway, sorry, completely off point.
All right, yeah, play the trailer.
All right. So I don't really have to, I mean, I'll explain it to you. Yes. But if you're watching the show on, of course, live on Twitch TV / the Beefiest Boys, or if you're listening to the podcast, the audio version, on whatever fucking Spotify, the Beefy Boys, you can look it up, you'll figure it out, you're smart, probably, maybe. Niji Sanji, you know it, it's a VTuber company. I realize that as I play this, and people who are listening aren't gonna see it, but that's okay, you'll figure it out, you're smart, so we'll play it here. Debut from Niji Sanji EN, and we're looking at anime characters. Now, I'll stop here and explain. So fuck off, suck. Calling saying Lamau Niji cucks. Fucking, that's not even a thing. Niji Sanji's Ian branch obviously started with three female branches. And then they went in and they did started doing male branches. Well, Wave 6, interestingly enough, is both. There are three females and three males, which is interesting. So,
yeah, that's kind of cringe. But...
Well, okay. Yeah, I mean, y'all are getting Niji. I mean, y'all are getting Hollow Ian male. So,
yeah, but not the
I
would
say
again.
That voice sounds fucking terrible.
There's no audio.
Oh, fuck! I forgot to play it through the thing. Whatever.
Whatever.
Y'all can watch yourself later. This is my the. Maria Marionette, the Chunin-Byu, whatever. That's my pick. You're awfully cute. This one, Aya Amare is the one I want to talk about. To much to my shame, unfortunately, not a lot of the Niji Ians are a little, for lack of a better word, woke. Unfortunately, mm-hmm. Most of them keep it to them fucking selves. My waifu, my beautiful fairy daughter, Pomu, Rainpuff, keeps
okay,
her fucking.
So how woke though? There's like
I'm getting there.
Woke.
I'm getting there. Is pretty terrible. So the most woke one was obviously Nina. She had a very big, doing a little roommate talk here. Her whole thing was her former character was like an out or. Persona was like just a former complete outright like communist full tanky mode. However, then she got a job and just completely dumped it. Many such cases.
Did she graduate or is she just low volume now or something?
Who, Nina?
Yeah, like did she stop entirely or
no? She's why would she have stopped?
Well, you said she got a job,
right? A job as a VTuber.
Oh, okay. I thought you were
yeah,
talking
no,
about
no, no,
that.
That's what I'm
sorry,
saying. Bitch started getting paychecks, and then the communism shit went out the window.
I see. Yeah.
That's how it works for most normal, rational people. And she kept it pretty to herself. What is I almost said Fanana. She did it too. But what's the other one? Alira. Alira has done some cringy stuff, but not too bad. But it got real bad when they introduced Yugo and the guy... air quotes, that's a girl in real life, which whatever, you know, reverse traps, that's fucking whatever. The worst part is Fanana, with one from the wave one, literally won't let people in her chat say trap anymore because it's a slur or whatever.
Unless she walked that back.
I'm not aware. If she did, I'm issuing an apology on the spot to Fanana. I'm not just kidding. Fuck you, fish.
In the first place.
Yeah. But then we get to this bitch to bring it all the way back. I am all right. Her literal first tweet was something just like loudly and proudly exclaiming she's gay. And then she did some big shit about like saying like, oh, you know, I respect men, women, both and neither. And it's a fuck off, which is a shame because that's a mommy model. That's a mommy model. Oh, yeah. For those listening, the model is it's gray haired, blue eyes, very motherly features, these glasses, a little bit of a, like a librarian look, but I won't say. In fact, what's her tagline? Angelic maiden, which is ironic because you just know. Mm-hmm. You just know. Mm-hmm. The carousel has been ridden. So that's fucking terrible. Looks like I've finally arrived. I'll say that guy's voice is great. I know y'all can't hear it, but this Rin Zoto, his alien prince is his character. He has a great voice. I don't know why he's not doing like anime VO or something, which he might. So now here's my pick. You could see it a little bit. Scarlet Yanaguni, Enchantress. You know who she kind of looks like a little bit. I don't know who would even remember this is Noor. From Niji Sanji India? No? Nobody? Okay, that's cool.
I mean, I'm not super familiar.
We're looking at this, like, the light black hair, red piercing eyes, kind of hourglass in earlier.
She does look like every anime attempt at, like, making kind of a Middle Eastern character, you know?
Yeah,
like,
that's definitely...
That's, like, how they always look.
That's definitely the vibe she's giving off as Middle Eastern.
It's like if you've ever seen like Full Metal Alchemist, like the Middle Eastern country in that show. Like,
right.
that's
yeah. What you expect. Yeah, they're gonna have a debut song, and let me see. You can't really see it. They showed it somewhere here in the beginning when they were doing the silhouettes, but that character, whatever her name was, that I just forgot. Oh, here it is. Let's fucking when the fucking stocking like pinches at the thigh meat. Oh my god, and like the vaguely like plaid schoolgirl skirt. Oh my god. Anyway, so that's our Neejis. They're gonna be live Saturday. Yeah, Saturday. Which, fun fact, for those of you who were fucking pissed off at Games Done Quick, ESA, European Speedster Assembly, 2022 summer starts Saturday. It's always a better show than Games Done Quick. It's not
they
nearly
seem much more same.
Oh, it's so much better. I love ESA so much better. Like, they don't have, so first off, like, let me just get this out here. The problems I have with Games Done Quick started way before they started in the clown world shit. Way before. My issue with Games Done Quick is that they cucked out corporate. And that, like, no fun allowed. We have to do all this shit. The uniqueness of it is gone. ESA, they don't give a shit. You can do whatever you want at ESA. It's great. They still do the clown world pronoun shit, but...
What killed... Games Done Quick for me, and this is rather late in the killing it for me thing, is when they were still stay home, self quarantine, people were streaming from their bedrooms with fucking masks on.
Well, yeah, that sucked. And then okay, so ESA came back last January, I believe, last January 2021, which was great. Well, no, they might have only come back last summer, but still, which was crazy because they're in Europe. Which Europe had way more stringent shit than we ever did. GDQ stayed all like remote until this summer. And this summer they came back and everyone had to wear a mask. Even the people at the fucking like host booth. Not sitting near anyone. Even the fucking people quarantined off into the corner running the host booth all had to wear masks, and you could like hear it, you could hear them wearing masks while they're I just didn't watch it. I just didn't like, that was the last straw for me. That was the absolute last fucking straw for me with Games Done Quick. So I'm fully an ESA guy now. I have always loved ESA. They have much better personalities. They're a lot more fun. They're still clowny. All speedrunning is. You can't get away from it.
Sadly, they are European, though.
So. They are European. A lot of Americans, though. Big John. In fact, Big John might actually still be banned from Games Done Quick. So he might be exclusive to ESA. Yeah, I forgot what he got banned for. Something real stupid. It was real dumb.
I do know they're very ban happy.
They're very ban happy. I think even Nagleria, I don't think he even still is big in the speedrunning scene, but I think he still even is welcome at ESA. So they're way less. I think the only people that are banned from ESA are like the worst people. Like, Wild Goose might be, but maybe not. I think most everyone's gotten over Wild Goose by now. So, or that's not his name. That's the fucking Fetty guy.
Yeah, maybe White Goose.
White Goose, yeah. Fucking I'm Fetty brained lately, fucking.
Anyway, I was about to say that earlier.
Yeah, that was my one thing on the schedule tonight. So did you want to do these OISs?
Sure, yeah. If you
which one of these you want to do? Let's do one. Let's pick one. Which one do you want to do? The one you linked?
Do the other one that okay. You linked. I think
we'll bring that. Ah, shit. I opened on the wrong fucking thing. All right. We'll pull this up. All right. So what do we have here? CERN is sign in to confirm. Nope. Mm-mm. Kill yourself. Open on the other one. Well, in Minecraft. Sorry. I'm demonetized for that one. Okay. All right. So we've got here. Burglary suspect gets shot in the arm during foot chase through Hollywood traffic. Okay. That's awesome. Walk us through this one.
Hi. Before, thank you so much for answering.
While we're just trying to get going, while they're probably scrolling the 911 audio. I'm surprised that California, of all states, allows guys to still foot chase.
Really?
You can in Chicago. Chicago, it's not allowed. You cannot engage in a foot pursuit. There was actually some audio footage the other day of a sergeant, a Chicago PD sergeant, telling his guys to stop pursuing murder suspects in a car.
Oh, Jesus. That's not good.
Another interesting crime stat for you guys that care. Do you know New Orleans only has a 6% conviction rate for violent felonies?
Yeah, I can 100% believe that. I only live like an hour away from New Orleans. Yeah, I can 100% believe that. That place sucks. That's why I don't go there. I have no idea who they are, and they're
trespassing. And I also looked at the security cameras, and I've seen them.
Real shame there's no audio on this, because there is some peak audio.
Yeah, all right, hold on, let me fix it real quick then. Hold on.
I was going to say, because there's some very good audio during the apprehension.
Okay.
I think would be very much enjoyable.
I think it's this button that doesn't. Packages that
were delivered to my
neighbor in the apartment below us.
It's a typical, you know, burglary, Airbnb fraud.
Mm-hmm.
It's two young men. You're stealing packages, stealing shit from the apartment. Been bringing stuff.
They arrived at around 8 o'clock this morning, and they brought things into my house. They used the keys. They knew all the codes to my gate and my garage.
Okay, so we've got here the video. Two young men who actually appear to be... I mean, I'm going to be racist here for a second, if you don't mind.
He's got a cane. I never noticed it the first time. My man's got a fucking cane.
I believe one of them is white and one of them is black, actually. They're walking through a parking garage, and yeah, the black young man in the foreground wearing... looks like a black tracksuit, actually. Actually does just straight up have a pimp cane. Very nice. Yeah, he has that. Yeah, one of them is actually white. He's actually pretty buff, too. That's good job, man. Oh. So they stop there at the what looks like a stairwell or something. And the white guy took his shirt off for some reason. He's got a black wife beater under it. They go move out of frame of the camera. Security camera switches to the next one that's showing the outside, the entry to the parking garage complex. But they are going through the top of the screen, which is through a doorway. Yeah, through a doorway. One of them went through. The other one, it's like they're waiting on something. So hold on, I have a question. So the woman was calling and asking about like her property or something, but these guys seem to now be in, is this where they found them or?
It's like an apartment, so I guess you must own an apartment.
Okay.
It's
that makes sense.
Typical scummy landlord shit. You know, she's subletting a sublet. Probably.
Sure. So yeah, the white guy is just milling about. What's that?
I have my own issues with Airbnbs as is.
It's
so scummy. Well, it originally started out as just like a bed, air mattress, bed and breakfast. That's what Airbnb stands for. And now it's like this massive, like, just typical, like, stops people from like getting housing and shit like that.
Oh, yeah. Didn't really have a big housing advocate.
Well, you know.
Instead of slumlording, dude. It's fucking slumlording.
Yeah, sure.
Like, a lot of Airbnbs nowadays have, like, fucking chore lists that you have to do.
What?
Yeah.
Yes. It's extremely common.
No,
and just anything that makes it more prohibitive for regular citizens to own housing kind of sucks, too.
Mm-hmm. All right, so the white guy just seemed to motion to someone. He's standing at the entry to the parking garage.
Oh, because it's some sort of burglary suspect thing. They're probably waiting for the getaway car to load up. You know?
Yeah. He's jogging away. Yeah. Okay. So yeah, it's someone has definitely showed up. There, security cameras moved to the outside of the parking garage.
He's moving.
The white suspect is indeed jogging quickly around the edge of it, looking. He just like straight up like. Oh, here we go. So now we're seeing the actual cop pursuit. He's found his guys. He's pulled the gun. Oh shit. Okay. So he just. What?
Yeah. No audio. Yeah. You've got no audio again.
It's not going to be able to go through on Discord because I don't think it can do...
We had it before.
Oh. Okay.
That's weird.
There we go. Now we got a little bit of audio, but it's like from your microphone.
Yeah, it's going to be from my microphone. That's how it works.
That's his workaround because there's no way...
Hold on. I know what I can do. I can turn the... We're very professional here on this stream. Oh, yeah, the automatically determined. So I'm just going to turn, like, the sensitivity way down.
Yeah, he got a round right in his arm right out there. Because he 100% saw it. It was grainy, but Well, the firearm.
Well, okay, so yeah, so for those listening at home, what happened was the police officer approached from the street towards the guy who was looking to go down a gated alley, and he pretty much immediately drew and fired. What was the rationale behind that?
You didn't see the firearm?
Actually see a firearm. Let's go back
a
little bit.
The firearm, yeah.
So, okay, we're going back to the beginning. So, yeah. Our guy, and what, it says Hollywood. So, did it say what road this is?
I don't know.
It's a busy one.
Stop now!
Okay, no, yeah, I didn't.
He ducks behind.
Right
there in his hand.
Is that?
Keep going. Look, you'll see.
Well, I'll take your word for it. So they're running. They're literally just running through this busy street. His arm is bleeding. He leaking pretty well. Can't really see anything. Half the screen's blurred because they're blurring out cars and shit. But they're still running down the street. He keeps pointing the gun at him. He just keeps like running back and forth, up and down the street. Oh shit! He's trying to get into someone's car.
Yeah, he's trying to get into all them fuck cars.
Well, these cars, by the way, which are active, people are driving down the street. There's people in them. So, and he is armed. So he's actively trying to carjack someone right now. And I assume, so he let off those first two rounds, but at this point, he has to be extremely cautious about letting off another round. Because,
yeah, I mean, you got to watch your back drop.
There is a lot of people here now. Like in that one, I mean, that alley was empty, more or less. So that was easy. But yeah, I mean, he can't do anything at this point, except chase him. Yeah, so he just keeps.
I watched that. When he shot the arm, he dropped the firearm into the grass on the side of the bay. That's why it's hard to see on your end.
Oh, okay. Yeah, so they just so he's still running down the street. He keeps trying to carjack people. This, I mean, the traffic's not moving. Obviously, it's LA. It's never moving. So they let off two more shots. It doesn't seem like they hit him, though. Or if they did, he didn't react at all. They hit him with a taser, but it seems like I can only see, like, one prong right here. I think the other one might have missed.
That or just not... a no good contact. Like if the easiest way to defeat a taser is just to wear a puffy jacket.
Yeah, sure. But
if those prongs are too close or just don't connect.
From what I can tell, I don't think it made contact because he's not. Yeah, he's not. It's like it's not even doing anything. He is. I mean, he is barely just kind of jogging at this point, and I'm hesitant to even use the word jog. It seems like if this guy even put like a little bit of more speed, he could just straight up like tackle this guy. But he has a gun, so maybe not the best idea. Yeah. So at this point, he's just walking. He's oh my God, you can see there his arm. He's leaking. Not fatally. Not like that one video we watched where I don't even think it was in America. It was the one where the guy came in through the revolving door and the guy just put two rounds and one hit the artery in his neck. And I mean, it squirted a solid 3 feet. And he was dead in 15. He was dead in 15 seconds, and maybe 30. So yeah, this guy's just casually walking by as the cops continue to follow him. Still going. There you go with the tackle. Love to see it. Good visage me on this guy, by the way. The tackle. Good hair. Head of hair. Balding a little at the back, but that's fine. Yeah, just absolutely tackled him. Love to see it. And that was the end of it.
Oh, the second body. No, this one's good.
This is
good.
A good one. Nice. So we got the cop here. We got the cop here in the car.
This is why I love LAPD, bro. Fuck it, the PR24, bro. The old attitude adjustment.
Dude, he's moving too. Like that first cop was just kind of gingerly jogging after the guy.
You don't know if he helped.
Sure, you don't know. He's got a gun. Does he have another gun? Does he have a knife? Who fucking knows? This guy is just straight up like sprinting. This guy just caught the winning pass. He's 20 yards from the goal line and he's giving it everything he's got. This motherfucker is moving.
He's at PR24.
What is that with the nightstick? That's what you're calling the nightstick. Yeah, he's ready to crack a skull. Yeah, he's running down. He's just booking it. On the ground. my God, yeah. And from that angle, you can see his hand is just red. It's just covered in blood. He got, yeah. I gotta imagine he oh God, yeah, look at his hand. You gotta imagine at this point, I mean, like, again, that was not a fatal shot. It could be given enough time. But based on the amount of blood he lost, he was probably starting to feel a little woozy. I'm sure he was fine. He survived, right?
Look at how nasty his hair is. You thought she's not been washing a good fucking minute. And this is where it gets good. This is where I like the options.
Oh, shit. Yeah, he's just straight up fighting. Oh, God, yeah. So, okay, so for those listening, his hair is just, it's great. Okay, it's a dirty blonde. It's, I don't even want to call
he's
it
got
a...
like that. He's got like that commie, like, everything is shaved except for the hair at the top.
Yeah, but the hair at the top is real. Well, I mean, I have that too. I have that too, but I have the good... you know, somebody youth haircut where it's well coiffed on top, but the sides are shaved. Yeah, but this guy, everything's shaved, but the top is just a fucking mess, a greasy rat's nest of dirty blonde hair. Yeah, this hasn't been watered. Fuck. This hasn't been washed in a week. It's just it's slimy and greasy, and it's like in locks. It's just disgusting. And he is he's just actively fighting.
It's very, very hard to get somebody who doesn't want to be fucked.
Yeah. I love
if you
that
move, I will fucking crack you.
I love that. Yeah, if you move, I will fucking crack you. That's, oh my God, I love it. He got in trouble for saying that, though, probably, but.
Probably.
Yeah.
But you know what? I've been chewed out.
Yeah, yeah.
So, yeah, boy, crying. I can't move my arm.
I can't move my arm.
That shit leaks when they fucking cuff him.
That I purposely put in front of me and moved. Yeah, I can't move him. Oh God. Yeah, look at this.
Watch this.
There is
watch
a.
It. Watch it when they move.
Okay. I actually believe when he said I can't move this arm. I believe it. That I mean, that as deep as that is, they probably hit some sort of nerve in his arm. He may have very little use. Oh God! Oh, it squirted. That was like a fucking like a fruit crush. That was a torrent of blood.
Yeah. And that's oxygenated blood too. Look at that.
Yeah, he's hurting. Those are very real screams of pain right there. So, oof.
You know what? Tough shit. Don't fucking.
Yeah, don't run for the cops. Don't fucking run from the cops. That's the easy way to get out of that one. Fucking. All right. So, out of 10, what would you rate that chase?
Not good, not bad. Solid 7.
Really? Okay. It's not bad. No, it's not bad. So.
I mean, it was well orchestrated. Yeah. Like, they. Good sound tactics. I have no issues with it.
What's the best chase you've ever been in? Not including the fence.
Well, the sad thing is the state that I work in, we barely can legally chase for six crimes. So
okay,
automobile theft is rampant. Arson, murder of the second degree, ag assault with deadly weapon, sexual assault.
Mm-hmm.
What's the last one? I don't remember the last one off the top of my head, but it's some weird esoteric charge,
right?
Like firing at a building or something.
Yeah, that's kind of weird.
Escape. So crime is rampant in the state I run in now. The sure. Shitheads have learned that you know, a lot of the WAMOs, they leave their luxury vehicles unlocked with the fobs inside.
Sure.
Because, you know, crime never happens in our town.
Never.
So, and it's very prevalent in a lot of shore towns. They will go steal a nice vehicle and take it up to the hood, use it in a couple crimes, and then usually torch it.
Well, that's a fucking shame. That's the reality of policing these days, though, unfortunately.
Yeah, you vote blue and you defund, and that's what you fucking get.
Yeah, unfortunately, and that leads to shits like Uvalde.
Yes, it does. It unironically does.
It 100% does. Like, people are
those
using.
Guys weren't afraid of getting shot. They were not afraid of getting shot. They were afraid of everyone's going to judge us
and losing their pension.
I'm going to lose my job. I'm going to get indicted. You know. Yeah. They were worried about dying.
Because
they were not worried about dying.
Yeah, because from an outside perspective, what I think is what was going through their mind is they were thinking of all the 10,000 things that could have gone wrong. So, okay, say they storm it, right? They start shooting the guy. Fucking little bullet pin goes through and you dome little Sally Sue in the head. And they're not going to praise you for stopping a shooter. They're going to put little Sally Sue's face on the front page of every newspaper across America. Lester Holt's going to be decrying, you know, the heavy-handed use of force by police that led to a little girl being murdered by a cop. That's what we're going to hear. We're not going to hear how he saved a bunch of lives. That's what you'll hear.
Yep.
So, and that's, unfortunately, I mean, that leads to, what, 16 children being murdered.
And don't forget, in media, the loudest voice is always the right one, apparently.
That's very true. Yes, it's very true. So, all right. Well, how do y'all feel about...
They're still fucking cowards.
Realistically, someone could have still Ramboed. In fact, a few guys tried, and they got, you know, fucking held back, but... Is what it is. Like you said, that's a whole special episode. Special Beefy Investigates. Uvalde cop police department. How do y'all feel about Thursday nights? Did y'all like this?
Oh, it's fine.
Okay. I mean, I'm largely indifferent because the way my schedule is, I just won't be here for certain episodes.
Sure. Yeah, I mean, it's all right. We're still gonna do After Dark on Friday nights. But here's the question I wanted to ask, because we started making Taylor Plays a Steam Library pretty much a weekly thing. Do we still want to do that on Friday nights as part of the After Dark? Because for After Dark, we prefer to give it a very unstructured outside of the Snake Pit. Very unstructured. I mean,
I would say that's content that could be friendly for Twitch, though, you know? So it's like...
That is, yeah, that is. That is. And something to think about. But then again, I don't know. Twitch is one of those things where it's so saturated at this point that organic, like just random clicks, you're very rarely getting. Would that change if maybe we were doing some sort of just like straight up gaming content? Possibly. I don't know. We could try that out. I think for this week, we're just going to have tonight just the show. But I think that's definitely a discussion that we need to have. Where do we put the Taylor Plays a Steam Library segment? I do think an after show on Twitch on Thursday nights where we do it would be good. And then we save, because one thing I noticed when we were playing the Ape game, Ancestors, was we gamed pretty hard during that segment, to the point that cannot upload the VOD of it because, well, very heated gamer moments. So it would be good.
Considering, we had this new segment for showing off games. Thursdays might be the night, you know, if somebody's got a game they really enjoyed, they could show it off.
That's a good point, too. I really enjoyed the Taylor Plays a Steam Library segment. That was that Bad North game. I still think about that. That was, if anyone hasn't watched the VOD for that, you can catch that on our YouTube. Again, I don't really have an easy link to that. Hey, great reason to go set up that Freedom Links or link tree after this. Because, I mean, it's hard to link to it, but that's up on our YouTube. As are all VODs. And, of course, if you miss this, which I don't know why I'm saying this, because if you miss this, you already know to listen. So why am I saying it? Whatever. Anyway, the audio version of this will be up on Spotify, Apple, whatever the hell you listen to tomorrow. Tomorrow morning, VOD will be up on YouTube. I'm really looking forward to Live PD tomorrow night, boys. Really looking forward to Live PD. You gonna watch it, Prude?
Oh, maybe. I mean, we'll see what's going on.
I hope that stream works. I really do. That's gonna be a pain if it doesn't. I'm hoping YouTube TV picks up Reel sooner rather than later. I wish they got to a Reel channel, man. I just fucking that killed. Whenever I saw Reels, I just went, what? But. Anyway, it's been fun, boys. It's been fun. Every Thursday night, twitch.tv/thebeefiestboys. We're here live next day on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, what the hell it's all called. Had a good one. We'll have a good one next week. And we will have a good one tomorrow night when we go and do the Hour After Dark, which is a lot of fun. No Snake Pit this week, though. No snake pit.
Who knows? Maybe something will come up in the next...
Yeah, hopefully in the next 24 hours, something happens. Well, here's one. What do we want to do time-wise on that? So do we want to do 11 Central, 12 Eastern for After Dark? That'd be a little late from when we usually would have started After Dark. But
I mean, it's not that late for me, but...
Right. But it is After Dark. And I do want to kind of... I don't want to... The point was to not overlap with Live PD too much.
Right. That's fine. I mean...
Because I do...
experiment.
Yeah, so... Let's... Yeah, you know what? Let's say 11. 11 Central. Tomorrow night. Shing TV. We'll be live with After Dark. We'll be gaming. We'll be doing the Taylor Plays his Steam Library segment. And what did we say? What do we have? Hold on. I got the list here.
Show off some Ready or Not or Tarkov.
Whoa. Hello. What the fuck? Did my audio just die?
Your audio got a little weird.
It did. Yeah. Yeah, I don't... That's just one of the random fucking recurring problems that I'm currently having on my PC that I can't figure out how to fix. So, whatever. I rolled, yeah, Night Call. I have no idea what that is. Tropico 3. I'm a little excited about that. Tropico's fun. XCOM Apocalypse. XCOM Apocalypse is one of those games that I'm just literally crossing my finger doesn't even fucking boot. Because I don't want to play. I already know what it is and I don't want to play it. Sniper Ghost Warrior 2. Pumped for that. I love the Sniper Ghost Warrior series. Graveyard Keeper. That's an interesting one. That might be one where I just kind of touch on the high notes and move on. Peaky Blinders game. Fucking what? More creds.
Yeah.
Don't know. Worms Rumble. Don't care. Children of Morta. Now, Prude, I think you said that was a good game, right?
I think that was one that I heard of, at least, because it's supposed to be like Children of Mana, basically.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And then Sid Meier's Railroads, which doesn't have very good ratings, but it's trains. So, yeah. So be here for that tomorrow. And that's all we have. Thanks, everybody, for coming tonight. And we'll see you tomorrow night and then next week on the show. So, see y'all later.
Yep.